Hello friends, today we shall discuss about episode 3. In episode 3, we shall discuss emitter biasing circuit. How the emitter biasing circuit can work and whether it is a stable against the thermal runaway or it is a viable to utilize in general, that we will try to learn it. Suppose this is emitter biasing circuit. As usual, it is RC given to the transistor and one more extra resistor is connected, that is name is R. Here base resistance RB. Now you see in this circuit we are connecting one extra resistance to RE, and that is why we have need to apply extra power supply to also RE. This is VE, and suppose this VCC you can mention like that. This is VCC. Ground. This is negative terminal of the VCC, positive terminal is connected to RC, RB, and one more supply is connected to VEE, and both supply, that means VCC less than or equal to VEE. This is the condition. Now let us start to analyze the circuit. Obviously, we are applying, this is input, output, and we are applying Kirchhoff's second law. VEE is equal to VBE IB R2. So VEE is equal to VBE plus IB R2, and that is why IBRB plus IERB. So VEE minus VBE is equal to IB RB plus IE RE. As we know, IE almost equal to IC. So I change this equation by IC to IE. even though base current you can solve in terms of IC. Why? Because beta is equal to IC upon IB, and that is why IB is equal to IC upon beta. So let us put this value. Resulting, we have the IC is common. And VB in compared to VE quite small. So we can neglect this term. So this equation becomes VEE is equal to IC into bracket RB upon beta plus RB. This is the most significant equation to analyze this circuit. IC is equal to VE upon RB upon beta plus RB. Now IE is almost equal to IC. So let me write IE is equal to VE upon RE plus RB upon beta. Now beta is here, that means IC directly omitted from this equations. That means this circuit cannot depend directly on an IC. This is the big advantage. So far that concern, what to do? That this circuit must be depend on IE is equal to VEE upon RE. That means RB upon beta is very much less than RE. Very much less than. This is the sign of very much less than. And that is why it is needed that RE has the bigger value, larger value. And once RE has the larger value, obviously we have to connect extra power supply to this circuit. So whole circuit, it's become independent of the beta, of the transistor. That's why it is stable against the thermal runaway, but it is not viable that you have to connect two power supply. Example point of view, I would like to tell you that you need a 5 volt of the applications. That's why you can connect the VCC more than 5 volt, but less than 6 volt. Okay. Further, you have to one more power supply attached, at least more than 6 volt. So, you have to apply two power supply or a single power supply with larger voltage. It means you have a need of 5 volt amplifications, but even though you have to apply at least 10 volt of the power supply. So, that is why this circuit is not preferable. Okay. Thank you very much, my friend, to listen me. Episode 3 is completed. In next episode, we will discuss one more subject.